This is the sound a Shop-vac makes when the bearings start to chatter, and if you don't oil it soon, it's going to be wrecked. This is a Torx T25 screwdriver. So here's the motor inside. This would be a good time to unplug your Shop-vac. Let's take out more of the screws. And that's all the screws we can see from this side. And that's the internal blower in here. These Shop-vacs are all pretty much put together the same way. And same screwdriver, there's two screws on either side of this blower. And this is the actual blower here. Now, we have actually at this point already access to the bearing in the back. The bearing in the front is a little bit more tricky to get at for lubrication. I have to get this thing off now to get at it. Now, some Shop-vacs will have a nut on here, and the best way to loosen that is to put a nut driver in an impact driver. This one just has some snap-on kind of clip on here, which I have to pry off with some screwdrivers. And there's our motor in here. So that's all there is to this motor. And let's take that apart even further. So on the rotor side, we have a ball bearing, and those tend to last quite a bit longer. So really, I didn't need to lubricate this one at all. It's more likely this one that was the problem, and that one I could get at without actually disassembling the whole thing, because I had access to that quite a while ago. Now, whatever you do, don't get oil on the commutator, because if you do, your motor's going to be wrecked. I'm just going to see if I can maybe try to get a little bit of oil into this ball bearing, just for good measure. And then on here we have a bronze bearing, and those typically are impregnated with oil, and there's a little thing around it that's also soaked with oil. So I'm just gonna soak everything on here with oil and leave that sitting for a while, and hopefully some of this oil will make it into the little sponge around the bearing and keep lubricating that later on. So I kept adding more oil, let that soak for a while. Let's get rid of the excess and I can put this motor back together. Now, to get the rotor back in here, first I have to get these brushes out of the way, and I'm just going to use a screwdriver to kind of pry one of them back, and now I'll push the other one back by hand while I get the rotor back in here. And now the brush is already caught on the rotor, except this one here is a little bit stuck. These can get stuck in the back sometimes. There, now it's loose, and I still have to kind of tap this a bit to get that ball bearing to insert in the plastic. Now, the tricky part is to make sure the cord comes out on the right side. And this is where the cord comes out here, so that means that goes on in this orientation. Sounding good. This middle circle flares up a bit. I slightly flatten it on either side just to tighten how it fits on here. And now it's actually quite tight, so I have to tap that on there with a hammer. Now this little float goes down, opening facing down, and that's there to plug it up if it gets full of water. And now that goes on here. Now realistically, I didn't have to take it all the way apart. All I would have had to do is put some drops of oil in here, and that would have quietened it. But it would have been very difficult to soak all the pad around the bearing. So this is a better fix. But if you're in a hurry, just take this cover off, put some oil in here, and it'll probably fix it. That sounds much better.